it up. Oh my goodness me, you jest, sir, surely. Let's do this, my friends, good grief. That is a lot of forces. We've got to get these guns off. Oh, look at that, what a shot, sir. Oh, good grief, sir. Look at that, those anti-cav spikes worked an absolute wonder. Hold, lads. Clear them, lads. Look at that. Look at this defense here. Look at this. What an absolute butcher's yard. Look how many men fell here. Trying to breach this place, but we set up these spikes here. Look at that. They did their job. What a wonderful sight. Greetings and welcome to episode 48 of my Empire Total War Darth Mod Great Britain campaign. And this, my friends, how we left it last time. We have a number of issues, my friends, to deal with today. The first is, of course, from the council, my friends, who have been absolutely exemplary. Once again, your advice has been absolutely brilliant. It really has. The first thing to come from the council's recommendations is port security. Now, our port security has been lackadaisical, to say the least here. We don't have sort of the regiments, or at least a regiment in place to protect the port from being taken over by sort of enemy ships moving into the port, destroying the port, bombarding the port, ruining the goods, ruining the sort of the infrastructure of the port. So we're going to institute a full-on sort of a full-on scale port security sort of check, as it were. Now we're going to include a massive amount of regiments, or one regiment at least, in each of our ports to make sure we have that ability to repel any sort of ships moving into the port and damaging that port, costing us a huge amount of money. And case in point, my friends, is here in Piraeus here. Look at that, absolutely completely smashed to pieces. It's going to cost us 10,000 gold just to get this port here in Piraeus back up to square, and it's not really going to do us very well here. We've got to spend 10,000 gold just to get this one port. So that's a case in point there. Secondly, many of the council are saying we need to get a naval task force into the Mediterranean, into the Aegean here, not only to secure this sort of coastline here along the Mediterranean and Romalia and Istanbul, but also to put pressure on Crimea. Now, Crimea is the absolute hub, the central trade point here for the Russians. As you can see, 81,000 gold is moving through here for the Russians, and as you can see, it is also a massive capital here for trade for France, Mughal Empire, Spain, Ottomans and Venice. So as you can see, they have a huge importance here, the Crimea. Now, if we were to rip this away from the Russians, it would put a huge dent in their economy. Now, not to say the economy is going to crumble, because they have a massive, as you can see, a massive empire, which could probably absorb some of the costs. But if you lost 81,000 gold overnight, that is going to really severely dent your coffers. And that's what we want to do. There's many council members also advocating that we actually launch an amphibious assault against the Crimea, landing here in Sevastopol, and then moving on to Crimea itself, and taking it and sort of, you know, locking down this region for as long as we possibly can, and disrupting that economy of the Russians, this trade of the Russians. Now, it might put us in very sort of bad books, as it were, with France and those others that rely on a lot of Russian trade, because as you can see, the Russians have got an incredible economy. They're sort of internal economy is absolutely massive, as you can see. If they're able to trade nearly 42,000 gold goods with France, 35,000 with the Mughal Empire, 24,000 with Spain, you can imagine the sheer magnitude of their economy. It is vast. But if we were to cripple that, even for a few years, if we were to take this and hold this against whatever's thrown at us, then we could really severely hamper the Russian sort of might, as with, because the bear is roaring very, very strongly at the moment, and we are just about holding our own here, as you can see. And some way Ottomans managed to get these forces into play here, and again the council have been calling for us to not only destroy the ships here, but to blockade the port here, so they're not able to sort of move out against us, and also to take Damascus and Syria, and potentially either hold it, but then again we would be surrounded by all of Russia's might, or to take it and then give it away to a nation that is not at war with Russia. So you get that sort of neutral nation there, one that can we already trade with, which means we get the additional trade from them, but one that Russia would have to go to war with to be able to get this territory off them. So we have to be careful what we're doing here. But the main call was to get a naval task force here, a British naval task force in here. Now, some of the council members also asked what happened to the Victory fleet. So we had a fleet, a naval task force that was actually led by HMS Victory, of course, that absolute jewel in the crown of the Navy. Now, I said mistakenly that it actually had to be put back into Britain, sort of, you know, to defend the waters around Britain, had to sail back to Britain to defend the waters around Britain. I was completely wrong. I checked, and actually it's down here. It's right the way down here in the Eastern Atlantic here. As you can see, this is the fleet here that has HMS Victory. There it is. Look at that. What an absolute joy to see. What an absolute wonder here. It is the first rate ship of the line. Look at this. An absolute wonder to see here. And it really is the gleaming light here in the naval force. But as you can see, we're actually raiding here the Russian trade line. Now, some of you are saying, well, man, move this immediately into the Mediterranean and get it to work, as it were. But consider this, my friends. This raiding we're doing here is actually pushing our income up. This other here, which you can see, there's 31,000 here, is actually, the majority of this is actually coming from this HMS Victory fleet raiding the Russian trade lines. If we move out of here, this will drop like an absolute stone. It really, really will. And we will be not having 87,000 as our projected income. It'll probably be closer to the 60, and we wouldn't have this. We've got almost 30,000 available to us. So we have to be very careful what we do here. So what we're going to do is this. We're going to move this fleet that's currently guarding the coastline here, Dover and Portsmouth. This fleet here, an able fleet. Look at that. What a wonderful sight here. Led by this Alfred here, the ship Alfred here. But look at the discipline here. Look at the echelons, experience this group has. It is wonderful. Absolutely packed to the rafters with wonderful, wonderful captains here. We have a fleet here that's going to have to do a lot of the work here of guarding, well, the British coastline, basically. So this is going to, we're going to have a huge call upon this fleet here. We're going to have to move this fleet into the Mediterranean if we want to sort of really do what the council's bidding here. Now, as you can see, we are putting more ships into the area here. We're going to put more ships into Portsmouth here. They're going to join this fleet here. We are going to make this fleet a full combat fleet, so these sloops will actually come out of here. I think we'd actually put to that end, because you've got 12,835 as sort of in the bank here. We might actually put some additional. Do we have any? We've got war galleons, but even then, I think it's going to be better if we have heavy first rates. We need that firepower. And you would have another one. We've got three ships already. They will be joining this fleet here that is currently guarding Greenwich. But it's going to have to, it'll have its hands full here if the Russians decide to move against Britain here in terms of the fleet. But we need to get military power. We need to get some power into Mediterranean. This is the only fleet we've got available that has the firepower to match the Russians, to match the Ottomans, to match anything coming its way. We have to take this gamble. We have to take this gamble here because we are under a huge amount of pressure, as you can see. We've also managed to hold Stockholm after a pretty brutal assault there by the Russians. Now, the Russians have sort of put, the, you know, reformed some of their army here together, merged them together, some of these armies, and they've put them into the field. Look at that, general there. Wow, that's a highly experienced general there. It really is. But we've also sent forth General Roberts here to deal, to confront these armies. It looks like they're heading for Norway. Many of the councils said it looks like they're heading for Norway here. Now, I know that a number of council members are also a little grieved that we've given money to Sweden because they see them as sort of a dying nation, as it were. Now, we won't be sending Sweden any more money. No more money will be going to Sweden, I can promise you that. That was just to sort of kickstart them to be able to hopefully put them on a firm footing so that we have them, have got to prop them up. But if we can deal with these two armies here, we've effectively reduced the presence here of the Russians in Sweden to just these forces here, the sort of harassing and haranguing our forces here. Ultimately, we're looking to take Finland. If we take Finland, we will give this to Sweden as well. What we need is we need Sweden. Our ultimate goal is to take St. Petersburg, to get that foothold upon Russia proper, as it were, and then to be able to move towards Moscow. That's the ultimate goal here. But to do that, we've got a few things still to do. We've got a few tasks that we have to ask our men, our navies, our fighting troops on the ground to do. The first is going to have to be rid ourselves of these forces. But these forces will absolutely cooperate with each other. If we attack them as they are now, they will work together to defend against this army. We need to try and hit them one at a time, eliminate them in its entirety, and then move on to the next army. If we can do that, we have a very, very good chance of actually achieving our goal here. As you can see, we've got a massive resistance to foreign occupation, absolutely huge here. Growth is almost, well, is negative, so growth is in devastation by army. So as you can see here, we're already looking pretty poor here in terms of what's happening if our growth. We've got a food shortage as well, so we've got a lot to do. We do have a naval hospital here as well, but we won't start putting money into that just yet. We can only get a third rate, and of course, heavy first rates are unavailable because we don't have the money to do that yet. But our first task is to send this combat group, this task force, which is also asked for by Lord Admiral Kavanagh as well, to be moved into the Mediterranean. We're actually going to settle and put this force into Pylos here. And also, as was recommended by the council, we're also going to start recruiting militia for port security. I believe, have we got an art? Yes, we've got. So we've got a regiment in here. We shall also do the same here. Where is our? There they are. Militia. We don't have any ports here yet, but we are going to make sure that all the ports here as well in Britain. And the council is, of course, right once again. We do, and we have overlooked that. What? Irish volunteer infantry? I think so, sir. An Irish... good grief. Connaught Rangers. Look at that. We've completely bypassed these gentlemen here. I think so, sir. We shall just put that there. Recruitment here. Oh, my goodness me. Scottish line infantry. You jest, sir, surely. Wow. We are definitely going to have some of those, but we must maintain what we're going to do here. Militia is vital here. Yes. Militia here as well. I think we'll put this line of infantry in here as well. Do we have? Yes, we do already. Do we have in here? Yes, we do. There are only a few missing. Now, main ports one here as well, which will definitely be needed. And to that end, we'll actually move a line of infantry into here. But as you can see, we have now got a combat group in here. And my word, that will be used. We can't move any further. We can't actually engage these Ottoman forces yet because we've actually come to the limit. These gentlemen have sailed hard here to get into the Mediterranean. I'm going to give them time just to catch their breath, and then they shall be moving on to duties. We've definitely got quite a large Russian fleet, though, loitering about. We need to know what's in here in the Crimea. Can we actually find out what's in? We can't know because we need to get rid of these Ottomans. There's a very good chance the Ottomans will either attack these armies here or attack Istanbul. We have prepared for that attack in Istanbul by putting a very powerful force here. Now, many of you have been also, many generals have been requesting for generalships. We've had at least four or five council members asking to become generals and be promoted to generals in the field. I can promise you that will be done. We've just got a few things to sort out, but next episode we will have those promotions going through. We don't quite have the armies yet to sort of fulfill those posts, but I can promise every single person who's asked to be a general will be a general. I can promise you. Don't think I haven't forgotten. I've actually got it written down, but we just need to sort a few things out first before we promote, because I want the before I promote the generals, I want them to be in the positions they're meant to be in. So a number of generals have been asked to be fighting against the Russians, a number have been asking to fight against the Poles. So I wanted to make sure that the generals were actually in place before or were going to be on their way before I actually promoted them, to make sure they're in the positions they want to be. So don't think I've forgotten, my friends. I can promise you I haven't, but we're just going to do this right. I think we're secure. As you can see, Poland's actually moved forces in here to sort of oppose what we have here. Luckily we could bring in these gentlemen up to full. And also look at that, what an absolute boon that'll be. These forces here will actually be joining this army here to complete this army. So we've got a very strong army opposing the Polish forces. We have very strong armies here and here guarding the borders. I know that looks like they're not doing anything, but believe me, there's a very strong chance that Poland might actually turn against us. They're indifferent against us, -2. So as you can see, this does not bode well for us for the future. So we've just got to be very, very careful, because Poland, as you can see, is absolutely pushing so hard against the French. They've even taken Stuttgart now. They've taken Croatia. They've quite clearly got Brandenburg, Berlin here in their sights. There's a chance we might just see the French push back to here. I don't think Poland are at war with... No, they're not at war with Spain. In fact, actually, Spain are a trade partner of theirs. So Spain is not going to help France at all. But our main goal is to secure the naval, the sort of the seas, the waters around this, our redoubt here, our enclave in the Mediterranean, but also to make sure that we position ourselves well here. We've got not the best fleet here, but thankfully we will have another ship and two more ships to be able to join this fleet very, very soon. Let's end the turn here, my friends, and let's see what happens here. Let's see what comes our way. Research, look at that, that's almost done. Fantastic. And oh, screw bridge is almost done as well. Ferguson Rifleman. I think we might then switch from here. -4 for nobility, but that's something we can handle. We might go for +3 to imaginations, +4 to justice administration. We might go for that then. We might just move down to getting shrapnel shot and then percussion shell or even explosive rocket. Yeah, we're not really or we might even get preserved foods to give us +2 morale in battle. We need everything we can get here. But let's end the turn, my friend. Let's see what happens here. Let's see what the Ottomans do indeed. Excuse my friends, whatever. A sup of tea. Now, where is Spain going exactly with those forces? Poland. Now they've taken it. Berlin has fallen to the Poles again. Wow, they are absolutely rampant here. And again, because they are backed by the might of the Russians. Wait a minute. Looks like we'll have to engage these Ottoman forces and rid them. And now that, that would be a... We need to get them further away. If they come closer to us, we need to separate them from this army here. No, they're not. By damn, that's going to be a tough fight right there. That is going to be a brutal fight. Enemy, right, so they've decided to attack us. Now we've got to take this fight. This will be a fight the likes of which we haven't seen in a long time, my friends. Now, they've got only one artillery here. And this is coming with three artillery, so we've got, my word, we've got to be on the ball here. We have to be. We've got three 32-pounders here, which are going to be vital here. And thankfully, General Roberts has got in his army the finest, the absolute finest we have here. We've got a good complement here of horse. They've got hussars. They've also got our Garde de Cheval. And they've got some Moskovsky Regiment of Dragoons, Ferguson Riflemen. They've also got the Simonovsky Foot Guards. Very, very good fighters indeed. Very good troops. But these not so. We've got Cossacks. We've got some light infantry. We've got to have a firm defensive position here. A very, very firm defensive position. We cannot. We could retreat. But they would simply come for us here. Who? Oh, that's right. Because this arm, this regiment here is not at full strength. We'll take this fight. We could retreat and bring the other army into play here, but I think we can do a lot of damage here to these armies. They've got to come for us. They're quite clearly going to be sending in a lot of reinforcements as well. Let's take this fight, my friends. We have to hold. This will be absolutely key. Even if we don't win this fight, we're going to send that army we've got in Sweden. And Stockholm is going to move out to engage those forces there. We have to do this, but we believe General Roberts is a wonderful general. He really is absolutely one of our finest, a veteran commander, and that will be tested to the absolute limit here. What a huge deployment zone. This is absolutely massive. We're going to steer clear here of this small town here, or hamlet. We've got to steer clear of that here. We do have, as you can see, the topography here of this battlefield here does slope upwards here. Now, this would be perfect for our guns. I know they don't need elevation, but it gives us, and also makes, oh, look at that. We've got this wall here as well, which might prove interesting, but we've got to sort of put ourselves almost along this way here. We've got to shorten our lines to be able to have reserves. We need reserves for this fight. But my word, we've brought the absolute finest. This is the absolute zenith here of the British Army. It really is. Now, straight away we bring our guns to bear here. I think we'll set them hither. Oh, look. Oh, my goodness me. That is an absolute joy to see, sir. It really is. Quick line. A quick line will devastate anything coming our way. As you can see, they have to come up through a valley here. There's a real massive valley here. Look at this valley here running through here. There's a real valley, as you can see, it slopes upwards here. But they're going to bring in a lot of reinforcements. We don't know from which angle they're going to come in from those reinforcements, but are we prepared? We are indeed, sir. 32-pounders. Look at the size of the bore on those. Absolutely huge. Now, we don't have the third... Unfortunately, the third horse is not in the best of shape. But they're going to have to do their duty. We've got General Roberts, who is going to sit on overview here. Look at that, what a wonderful sight here, sir. If General Roberts succeeds here, we might consider a promotion to Field Marshal. That is the scale of the task at hand here. Now we're going to put our finest here. I think we've got one regiment of 28th Foot Guards Marines. They will actually be in the vanguard of the defence here. Listen to that wind, my friends. It is absolutely blowing a gale here. Oh, what a sight. If that doesn't warm the cockles of your heart, nothing will, sir. Now, do we just push them forward just a smidgen? We need to make sure we've got enough room here to cover all angles. We will be on the defensive here, so even the cavalry will be on the defensive. Now, we've got some green units here, these regiments. 60th, 61st, 66th. I think we'll put the Royal British Grenadier Guards here. We'll put the 12th Regiment on their right. We are talking the absolute finest troops you can possibly muster here for the British Army. Look at that. Against two very, very well-rounded Russian armies here. I'll put the 74th. No, actually, we'll put the 13th. We'll have two Royal British Grenadiers sort of straddling, as it were, either end here. That is, I mean, that is as a strong a central defensive position you can actually find here. Three of the absolute finest, the apogee here of British fighting forces. Now, we might hold these three these regiments here in reserve if possible, but we might have to include them as well. Now, the 57th is and does have combat experience. We'll put them here on the right. Now, although we could probably assume that we'll probably get some Russian forces coming from this angle here, and to that end, put the 74th British Fusiliers here. But as you can see, that the deployment zone is not going to allow us to move all of our forces where we want them to be, so we're going to have to rejuggle our forces. Actually, we'll probably put the gentleman onto round shot for the time being to get that range, especially with 32 pounders. I mean, yeah, that's a good range there, 32 pounders, very nice range indeed. That will set us up very well here. Now, we need to pull some forces back in reserve. We're going to need that. But we've got to have our lines nice and compact here. So we've got the 74th. We also got the 76th, 75th here. We really do have General Robertson. He does have a wonderful army here. Now, that's probably the most we can do at the moment here in terms of a defensive position to start with. And we've still got a number of forces available still. Where's our cavalry? Let's pull our cavalry up to here. Thank you, gentlemen. Now we've got the third horse. Oh, everything else is up to full strength. We might actually pull a few of them off to the flank here. We might put 24th. Actually, we'll have the 3rd and 24th horse guards off here. Maybe we can catch some of the Russians in... What the blazes are you up to, sir? We'll have the 24th and the 7th, I beg your pardon, here on this flank here, just to catch any Russian forces that are either fleeing, or if they, we can hide them in their flanks to really put them on the back foot. We have to disrupt their lines, but we also need reserves here. I think we'll have the 3rd and the 23rd in reserve. Push General Roberts forward slightly here. Thus. Now remember, we are going to shift our lines as when the deployment ends. We've got 60th, 61st, 66th, 67th here in reserve as well. And again, they will be here, but we are going to move them. Where's the demarcation line? Oh, it's way back here. We can actually shift our forces up along here if needs be in reserve. We can even shift them around to here if needs be. We've got a 7th Grenadiers, which we definitely want on this left flank here. So they'll actually put here, ready to move into position. Last but not least is the 76th Regiment of Fusiliers. I think we'll put them here on the right, ready again to move. Of course, these will be moved and deployed depending on where the Russians are. I think we've got all our forces now fully prepared. We've got cavalry out on the flanks here, ready to move in. But the majority of the Russian forces are quite clearly going to come in from here. And also, remember, they've got reserves, which will come directly in behind the line. Look at the size of the deployment zone. It is massive. But we now sit prepared, sir, to meet that threat. Every single one is behind the British lines. Let's begin. Oh, my goodness me. Look at the sheer magnitude of that Russian force moving there. Good grief, that is a lot. Let's shift. Double time, gentlemen. We're going to move back these. These are our reserves. We're going to move them back to here. Actually, what we will do is we'll just divide them up so they can cover each the flanks depending on what happens. That is a lot of firepower coming our way. But we stand prepared, sir. We're trying to move. At least we've got reserves, which is absolutely crucial. Ah, a Regiment of Horse. Now, this is why we've got these gentlemen out here, standing prepared to meet this threat, but we're not going to move out just yet. There's those third pounders here. Remember, the Russians decided to attack against us here. Gentlemen, Cuirassiers, look at that, sir. Steady that, steady now. Wait for the order. Look at that. It is winter, sir. It is absolutely brutally cold here in Sweden. But even these men, they do not even shirk at the cold, sir. We'll set them up to be here. I think that's probably just enough here. Here they come. Here they come. Got a quick line. Got a quick line. Oh, my compliments to the chef, sir. Put the 60th Regiment straight away into the... They're going to try and flank us. This is going to be a brutal charge here. Oh, what a shot, sir! Steady, lad, steady now. Get into them, lads! My compliments to the chef, sir. Hold back, lads. Oh my goodness me, it's an absolute massacre! straighten the lines. Keep firing, lads! Oh my word, what an absolute joy to see, sir! Engage the enemy! I'm gonna pull these reserves in. On this flank here, it's going to come under a lot of pressure. Oh, what the... There's those guns. Come on, gentlemen, get in it. Break, shatter them. Yourselves into position, gentlemen. Oh my goodness me, what an absolute massacre, sir! My compliments to the chef. They haven't faced anything like this. Look lively, lads. Oh my goodness me, they have fought with distinction here, this army. My goodness me. It's an absolute rout, sir. Hold, gentlemen, hold. How is this line looking here? Much, much firmer. Gentlemen, this is not a Sunday stroll. Move, sir! This has been an absolute butcher's yard, sir. Let's get out. Absolutely butchered. Absolutely. What the blazes is going on here? Oh, look at that. They've already shaken. Of course they are, sir. And we shall soon rid ourselves of all artillery here. The Russians have no fire support at all. Oh, look at that. All their fire support is gone. The ground here where they are. They're shattered. Oh, what a joy to see. What an absolute joy to see here. We can actually probably move these around here to shut the door on them. Cossacks. Oh, they're going to pay the ultimate price here, my friends, I can assure you. Gentlemen. The cavalry has worked wonders here. That's more like it. The council has also advised we aim at the ground before the enemy. And thus that is what we shall do. Oh my goodness me, we have absolutely... General Roberts, you can be proud, sir, of your army. It has worked absolute wonders here. And thus it shall be so. Oh my goodness me, what an absolute butcher's yard this has become here. Diamond formation, lads. Finish off these Russians. Show them who commands, Sweden, sir. Oh, the very finest, sir. Ah, anti-horse spikes, I see. It's been an absolute bloodbath, it really has. choosing, sir. Watch those spikes, lads. No, gentlemen, move away. We've absolutely butchered this, or shall I say General Roberts has absolutely, we have annihilated these Russian armies here. This has freed us up to move completely at will now in Sweden. What a battle here. This proves the value of the troops we have available to us. One British army of this caliber can eliminate anything in its path here. Oh, look at that. I mean, look at that. Halt. Ceasefire. Nothing remains. Nothing remains. Yes! Oh, what a fight that was. What a fight. That was an absolute joy to see. Good grief. We lost 651 men. We killed 4,500 Russians for the loss of 651 men. Good, look at the Royal British Grenadier Guards. Please, gentlemen, can we raise a toast? A toast to these gentlemen here. What an absolute wonder. Only, look at that. They lost 16 men. They killed 278. I mean, there is no words to describe the sheer magnitude of what they've done here. They have single-handedly broken the Russians. What a fight that was. On your way, sir. We're going to track those down and we're going to eliminate those armies. Don't even think about it. And they have. Sweden. We need Sweden to do something here. Ah. What a fight that was. Indeed, so we shall take that peace treaty. They've asked for nothing, they've received nothing. We shall accept it. One less enemy. Maybe. Wait a minute. That's fine. I guess we're going to take a little bit of a hit here. We are indeed. But still, we can. We don't have anything in here at all to deal with the Russian force. That. Those Russian forces will prove a problem for us. Now we're going to have to, it seems, invest in our own forces in this area. We immediately reinforce here. Thank you, sir. 24 pound. Now this army is starting now to. I mean, look at this. That is an army and a half right there. We're probably going to need. And we do have four cavalry. We're probably going to need line infantry as well. As the council also said, we mustn't overlook the effectiveness of the line infantry. We do have 20,000 remaining as well. Ah, they're also hitting that trade route there. Great. Oh, we've been completely cut off here. Look at the size of that Russian fleet. It's not as excellent. So call in there. Enemy raid here. So quite clearly the Ottomans haven't got the. So I think we shall move in and remove this. Oh, imagine they got two organ guns, 24 pounders. That's a brutal army right there, and they've got a lot of cavalry. What do we have available to ourselves here? we've got lots of cavalry of our own here, including some Lancer Guards. Hussars were also mentioned as well for us to be able to do here. Now, why isn't this army fully replenished? If you would please, sir, thank you. Ah, excellent. Now they're going to... Oh, they can't be able to make it there just yet. We don't want them being intercepted by that quite large army there. Excellent. We can also upgrade this as well here. The dry dock here is going to be upgraded to it. That's going to be a dry dock. And Glasgow is at now full trading here, so that's why our trade income has gone up. Yes, it has. Our tax income has gone up almost to 40,000 nearly. Classic economics has also gone up as well. Happy drinker, plus one morale in battle. Excellent. But we do need to deal with these Ottoman forces here. Put 10,000 into there just yet, but it looks like the Ottomans are sending forces in to oppose each one of our armies here. But we're going to have to pull one of these armies out to deal with this. Yeah, they've got organ guns as well, and a lot of cavalry. We've got to deal with this threat because they're quite clearly going to move towards us. We need to deal with these as well, I think. But first and foremost, let's deal with this here. Ah, a large Russian force here, sir. But that won't stop us. Prize money awaits. The oceans are ours. Ready for action. Aye, sir. We shall move to Thessaloniki. Now that's cleared here, we can actually move. Put to sea. Yes, your majesty. And we're going to replenish. We need to find out what's happening in here. Ooh, that's a large force there, but what's happening here? Oh my word, that's a massive fleet there. What do they have? We're going to have to sacrifice. Good grief, look how many fleets they've got in this area here. They have got a lot of fleets in this area, my word. I think what we will do is we'll dismantle this and make this into a... And actually, this is going to be a dry dock here. What can we recruit from here? Nothing that's going to put us in any substantial. We've got to just bide our time here if possible. Now, we've rid ourselves here of this, but these Russian fleets are quite overwhelming here. We have to deal with Crimea. It has to be taken. That's dropped over 53,000. That's dropped like an absolute stone there. They've lost about 40,000. We also need to deal with Damascus here as well. But our first task is to deal with the remnants of these forces here. Wipe them out. We are triumphant, ready and waiting for all. Grind them into the dirt. And we shall do that, sir. And after this trail of destruction, we are going to bring all of these back up to full strength here. Let it be known that we shall not yield, sir. Now that's going to give us what? -50% reduced unrest. Do we really need that at the moment? We need to probably focus Oxford on... Oh, mass production. Oh, that's more like it. I think we'll have Oxford have mass production. That'll reduce our costs massively here. Poland has absolutely just swept everything before it here. I mean, they have taken everything. All they've got, I mean, that's the high tide mark now of the French sort of advance into the east, which is Dresden. I don't think that's going to last too long either. France really is in a real sticky wicket here at the moment. Now, we almost have General Ernoux's force ready. We could upgrade this just now, but we're not going to. Do we have these gentlemen already? Here we do indeed. Port security is going to be a priority of ours. Got a port security here. Probably got one there. Probably here as well will do us good as well. I think we'll put a light dragoons into Portsmouth. Just to make sure that nothing happens here. Excellent. Ideally we need to get the victory fleet into here as well, but to do that we'd have to put another fleet into the field, and that's gonna really actually the naval upkeep is very, very low. If we get the tax income to nearly 45,000, that would probably deal with this. Look at that, that's jumped to 49,000. Wow. I think we are going to probably increase our our presence here. Let me look at that there. We can't leave Greece to its own devices here. We'll have one more line infantry guards. We're going to put 24 pounders into here. Well, Cuirassiers. We should also have here, we've got a huge fight developing here as well around Istanbul. That is going to be a titanic fight. And I think we'll probably take that one next turn, my friends, but next episode, I beg your pardon. But I think we're going to move in this army here to fight. Now, this is probably going to be General Brockmeyer's army. We then have General Futcher as well, which will be his army here. In which case we shall put a general in here as well. And we have a number of other council members that have also been asked to be generals, which that will happen as well. But we need to deal with these Ottoman forces as soon as possible. And I believe that this force here, of General Brockmeyer will be moving in here to engage the Ottomans. And that, my friends, is where we're going to end this episode. And it's going to the next British episode is going to start on quite a bang here. We're going to have a massive fight here, because as you can see, this is not a weak Ottoman force at all. They've actually equipped themselves with two of the most powerful sort of anti-infantry guns you can possibly get, which are the organ guns here. They've got 24 pounders as well. They've brought in their own musketeers and also the hand mortar Boluk, which if they get close to you, they can absolutely just wipe out an entire regiment in one go. And they've also bought their grenadiers, more musketeers. They've also got some Kurdish hillmen, some Israelis, a lot of camel nomads as well. But we stand ready here to meet them. We stand ready here to meet them with a highly elite army here. We're also going to engage that other army that's there as well. We'll pull an army off the border, and that will be used to engage the other Ottoman force. But this is the fight we'll be taking next episode, my friends. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, my friends. If you have, please leave your comments coming down below. Thank you for all your wonderful comments up to now, my friends. It's been absolutely fantastic. It really, really has to read all your tactics, your plans, your strategies, and they have helped shape and form where we are now at the moment. As you can see, I've tried to implement as many of your plans, many suggestions, many of your tactics and advice as I possibly can. The port defences are now sort of firmly in place. Security is in place. We've engaged and sort of removed the Russian threat from Sweden. We've also moved in now our own combat fleet now into the Mediterranean, into the sort of Aegean. We're trying to scout out Crimea. As you can see, they have a huge naval presence here in the sort of the Black Sea, and you can see why, because the majority of their trade is coming from the Crimea. But if we were able to manage to land a force on the Crimea and take it, it would be a brutal blow to the Russians. It really would. It might tip the Polish into war with us, but we would be prepared for that. We are starting, as you can see, to start to build our forces now in this enclave here. But as you can see, my friends, we have done reasonably well here. We've managed to secure Sweden now of those four of those Russian forces. I think we can possibly move out now as well and start looking at possibly taking Finland, and putting another army, which we have in Britain now, into Finland with the other army that's fought in Sweden for a long time. And then we're going to take Finland. We'll probably give that to the Swedes so we can move on to St. Petersburg. That is our ultimate goal. St. Petersburg is the prime location for the British Army in the north at the moment. It really is. If we can take that, then we stand a very good, very, very good chance of striking against Moscow. But that's some ways off yet. We have to deal with the immediate threats of the Ottomans, who of course, for some reason, have somehow managed to get these forces in a position. We might even launch our own attack against Damascus and remove the Ottomans, because they've been an absolute thorn in our side. And many of the council members have been asking us to remove the Ottomans. I think once we've dealt with them here, we might even use this force here of General Brockmeyer to actually move into Damascus, take Damascus, and then probably give it to possibly a neutral faction of maybe a trading partner of ours, and a faction that the Russians won't attack, possibly even Spain. Spain could probably hold their own against the Russians, so we might do that, my friends. But I hope you've enjoyed this, my friends. If you have, please comment down below, keep your comments coming down below. They've been absolutely wonderful, they really have, and I read every single one. I try to comment and reply to every single one I possibly can. I really do appreciate your advice and your tactics, your help. It's been absolutely wonderful, it really has. But next up will be the USA campaign. I know that we haven't seen the Russian campaign and the Spanish campaign yet, but what we'll do is I'll do the USA campaign for the week coming up, and then next week will be the Russian and the Spanish campaign. There's a chance I might be going away for 2 weeks, working away for 2 weeks, on from the 18th of March. So there might be a slowdown there on the number of episodes coming out. I might have to do just Nation's Guide then, because unfortunately where I'm possibly staying, the internet and Wi-Fi is not brilliant, to say the least. So anyway, I'll have to see what happens. I'll keep you updated on that. But my friends, this is the end of this episode. Hope you've enjoyed it. Hope you have a great week coming up. Please be safe whatever you do, my friends. But until then, bye for now.